For the very purpose where Google has created Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides for the applications like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint respectively, Google has now done the same for Jupyter Notebook and has created the Google Colab. So today, we are going to look at how Google Colab makes it easier to work with Google Sheets to analyze data. Before we get started, we'll require some data. For this tutorial, the dataset was taken from Kaggle about Airbnb listings in New York for 2019. You can download the data from here. Since I've already downloaded the dataset in my computer, we can see that it is in .csv format. Now we have to import the .csv into Google Sheets file. So first, we have to drag the .csv file to the Google Drive. Then right-click on the file and open with Google Sheets. This opens the .csv in the Google Sheets. Next, we have to create a new Colab notebook to navigate the Google Drive. First, we'll click on New, then we'll hover over More, and then we'll click on Google Collaboratory. This opens up a blank Colab notebook. In the following steps, we'll be coding in the Google Colab Python notebook. We'll import auth from Google.colab, gspread and Google credential from 0auth to client.client. Basically, these lines of code handle authentication and allow us to communicate with Google Sheets. When we run this, we'll be prompted to enter some credential which Google will give us by following the link provided. We'll also import Matplotlib, which is a powerful Python library for data visualization, and Pandas, which is also a Python library for data manipulation and analysis. To access the Google Sheet, we can simply use the gspread open by URL function, which we can access by the GC object we've defined above in the workbook object WB. Next, we'll call the specific sheets from the workbook by calling the worksheet function of the workbook object like this. So, to extract all of the values from that particular sheet, we'll call the getAllValues function on the worksheet object sheet on object called data like this. If we simply call data object from above, we'll just get back a list, which could be annoying. So, in order to make it usable, we'll convert it into a pandas data frame. The first line above is putting the data in the pandas data frame. And the next two lines is just some simple cleanup that uses the first row as a column names for the data frame. Next, we'll just call the head function of the data frame. We can see the data from the Google Sheet into this Colab. However, there is a problem with this data. When we call one of the cell by this, we get back a str. So, we are going to do a couple of things. First, we'll fix the issue of missing values in the reviews per month column by using an apply function and a lambda statement saying if the value of the cell in the column is equal to empty, then we replace it with 0 like this. Similarly, we can do the fix for the other columns in the same way using the stype function to solve the type issues like this. Now that we have the new schema determined, we can convert the above dictionary into a new pandas data frame that we can use to analyze and visualize the data like this. We can see that tabular values are much readable and manageable. We'll start with the basic analysis to showcase the power of Google Sheets and Colab. First of all, we'll display the most popular neighborhood group for Airbnbs in New York like this. When we run this, we can see that we get the outputs for the most popular neighborhood group. Next, we'll try to display the most popular neighborhood for Airbnbs in New York like this. Run this, we can see the outputs for the most popular neighborhood for Airbnbs in New York. Now, we'll try to visualize the histogram for unit pricing per night adjusted to not include outliers in the following lines of code. When we run this code, we get this histogram of prices from range $0 to $750 per night. Next, we'll visualize the neighborhood group density by importing Seaborn for beautiful visualization. When we run the following lines of code, we get this neighborhood group heat map displaying its density. Similarly, we'll also visualize each of the neighborhood density and display it in a heat map like this. Run this. We get this colorful looking heat map.
these are the few things we can do with in Google Colab.
Also, there are lots of wonderful things that we can do with it. Thank you for watching this tutorial on Google Colab and Google Sheets.